Dr. Sandra Lee here. Many of you guys may also know me as Dr. Pimple Popper. I'm here to show you some of my favorite videos. One of the most popular pops that I showcase are pilar cysts. Pilar cysts are a specific kind of cysts that most commonly occur on the scalp. In this case, this guy, he had just one cyst. And what's really cool about these is they're really thick-walled cysts, so they oftentimes pop out whole, and that is particularly satisfying to us popaholics. But it wasn't a little circle. Usually they look like more like an olive or just like a garbanzo bean.
Got it.
In this case, it was literally like a little horn that popped out of his head.
So let me pull the rest of it out here. I can see why it was kind of in this pushing against you. That's why it kind of got a bump on one side. Mm-hmm. But there's just a little bit of tissue here. I'll just take off just in case.
These are really common. They're benign. They're not life-threatening in any way.
Okay, I'm gonna cut through it and see, because it's like a pilar cyst and it has it's more homogenous than
pus.
No, it's not pus. It's actually macerated skin. It's like skin that flakes in there. So it's like wet skin that's just been sitting under it.
See how excited I get about these popping videos? And I know a lot of you guys get excited about them too, and that's why they're so popular. This one video is really something that truly pops out of the skin. It's called, "Can You Spot This Blackhead on the Upper Lip?" And I called it that because initially I really couldn't see this blackhead on the upper lip. You can't see it unless she really kind of stretches her skin on her upper lip. And then it looks just like a little button or a disc. And so what's really satisfying about this kind of blackhead is that if you just numb the surface of the skin and you make a little nick in the surface of the skin, it pops out or slips out. What I try to do when I do an excision on the face is really try to minimize the excision line as much as I can and really hide it in regular kind of folds in our skin. And so on our upper lip, usually I will try to make an incision in this direction because we want to hide them in our regular purse lines, or what some people might call smoker's lines, because that makes the excision line, the resulting scar there, much less visible.
It's like a little river rock. See this thing? Like popped out like a little pebble actually.
And oh my gosh.
It's like a disc. It looks like a river. It's kind of hard. It does. It feels pretty firm. But let's cut through it and see. You care? Yeah. It's kind of cool, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. See? Kinda cool. What your body does.
It is cool what your body does. I think it's just a cyst. It just got trapped under there and never opened to the surface. So since it's a very delicate small area, I've got these little baby sutures in here. And we're gonna take these out in like 5 to 7 days.
Okay.
More on the 5 side, I think.
We were able to make a tiny little incision on her upper lip and get rid of that annoying button blackhead, and now you can't even see that she had anything there in the first place.